Okay, I think we are good to go. Okay, so today we're gonna go back into some sketch cards. Just had to double check some troubleshooting things. So you can go ahead and jump into it. Yeah, this week I definitely want to try do a bit more low speed stuff so I can get used to just in general talking. Let's check and see how that's looking. Nice. Yeah, because I'm thinking, still kind of thinking about what I want to do with this channel. I know I want to do art, but I don't want to do art every day. Like, depending on, because right now we're working on trying to get a hard wire set up in my bedroom, because it's two bedrooms away from where our main router is. So we're gonna have to set aside a day to where my parents can help set that up for me. So until then, I don't know if I'll be able to, my MacBook will be able to handle like gaming stuff. It's already struggling this morning with just doing this simple setup. So we'll see how it goes. I know for me, if I do gaming stuff, I want to definitely incorporate some type of art related thing into it. Because I definitely want to have that to engage a little bit. Be like, oh, you know, I made this. I definitely like, I think that's my favorite part about being like a creative type person. Just being like, oh, you know, I made this. Just the craftsmanship and seeing that you were able to do something on your own, I think is really cool. Mm-hmm. It's kind of looking like zippers, like, you know, zipper pulls, that kind of shape. This one right here seems really long and out of place, the one up top here. But that's okay. Can maybe extend some of the other ones. So I'm planning on filling them in. Okay. I was debating whether or not to get a camera mount that attaches to my desk, but since you're drawing, you're shaking the table, it's probably not a good idea. Okay, I'm gonna pause the music real quick and verify that our microphone is still working. Because that was the issue we had a lot yesterday. Okay, we are good. We are good. Music is going back on. I think that's the difficulty with doing stuff on your own. Like, you don't have someone else to help you troubleshoot. That is definitely difficult. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead, color these in now. My goal today is to do three cards, because depending on level detail, it takes 30 to 40 minutes for one card. This one's probably gonna be a quickie. They also kind of look like teeth, the shape a little bit. Like, you know, the roots. Some funky teeth. It's another reason why I like abstract art a lot, because you can see different things and kind of like, you know, the Rorschach test. Kind of want to straighten this edge. There we go, a bit better. There we go, I think that'll be a bit better to see now. I think it's so satisfying to color in. So much fun. Like, half my Instagram recommended feed is just like art videos. Because you know, when a video is playing, you're just going to want to sit around and watch it. It's bad. Like, I can just be on Instagram scrolling for way too long. And that's the reason why, like, I try my hardest not to use TikTok. Like, I got it just so I can get my user right. Well, what sucks is that, like, TikTok will play the video right when you open the app. Like, it's bad. I'm debating whether or not I want to add color to this one. Just looking at it, the black already is a nice contrast against the white. Okay, now we're all colored in. Let's throw some art terms towards you. So if we look, this right here, this white line is called an implied line because it's not an explicitly outlined, right? Because the shapes and forms along the top and bottom are put along that imaginary line, so therefore it's an implied line. That's definitely my favorite, I guess, art term to apply. I think it's really cool. Kind of trippy almost. I'm so glad y'all couldn't hear me drinking the water, dude. I'm just gulping it down. Okay, see what else we can add to this. I kind of want to add like lines along the edge, just single lines. See, that adds a little bit of movement. Let's just add three lines or plume for now. Yesterday during my first stream, the one that was scuffed, I basically almost talked, I'd say for about like 60% of those 2 hours. And I can't imagine like just talking for 8 hours. That's insane to me. Like, how does your voice not go out? Like, shout out to those daily streamers, dude. Like, I can't imagine. I can see how outsides look a bit more gray, because that's a solid black, right? Solid white, and then a bit more gray because the lines, you know, like cross hatching. I kind of want to add some white to the center of those teeth shapes. I don't know what shape to add though. Maybe something here. No, I think it looked better here. Maybe just like a small rounded rectangle would look good. Yeah, that stands out a lot. I find myself using the white gel pen to add a bit more of like highlights on my other like black and white abstract work. So it adds a little bit of pop, you know? Ah, it clipped. Okay, we're good. It's nice because these gel pens dry pretty quickly. So unless you intentionally smear, it won't cause too much damage. Okay, let's check in. Nice. Really liking how this looks. I think this one is simple enough to where I don't really have to add anything else. Like, I think this looks great as is. This kind of looks like one of the cards I did yesterday. This one. It's kind of got that same curvature. Now, as you can see, the the lines do create that kind of gray shade. So I think this one, we're good. Go ahead and set this aside. Nice. Got that one done in 20 minutes. Cool. Because, like, sometimes I'll make doodle pages, and then I will make cards based off of a part of the doodle page. So this one is going to be based off of another design I did before. This one is actually, had to be like 2 years, no, 3 years ago now. Where I drew on my wall. First I did kind of like this. Just abstract patterns with acrylic, and then I did like 2 square feet of patterns, and it got to the point where like this hurts my wrist because like paintbrush, it's so hard to do against like a flat standing wall. So I started using Sharpie on my wall, and our walls are textured, so it's got like little bumpies on it. And when I was little, my parents told me like, oh, that's normal, all walls come like this. But like I'd go to other people's houses and they'd have like the smooth finish. Maybe they're just gaslighting me, I don't know. But so I did about 6-7 more square feet of patterns with Sharpie, like different widths. Like I used the regular fine tip, ultra fine tip, and like then the big chisel ones. Then I stopped because it was just got boring. Because the plan was to have the wrap design go across my whole room. But then it got to the point where like I said, I got bored of it. And then just was rewarding after the point. I also painted my door. This isn't in my room anymore because my sister and I changed rooms recently. So it's all in her room. And she still hasn't painted it over yet. Because I was like, do you like it? She's like, not really. But she's like, I don't want to go over it because you did it. It's like, okay, that works. Okay, so that's our base sheet that we have. I'm going to go ahead and go in with our micron liner for this one. I'm gonna make them rounded shapes for this one. I don't want them to be too pointy. That's the thing I like about watching people do traditional art as well. You can see the different strokes they make. Because with digital, you just see a cursor on a screen, so you can't really see like what specific way they turn their brush. Or which way they tilted their pen. You know, because it's little things like that, IRL, I guess, that affects what shape and lines you make. I did digital for a little bit. Granted, it was really bad. It was just simple line arts with simple block fills. Like, I know how to do basic photo editing, nothing too complex, though. Because the thing with like VFX is being able to make things look as realistically rendered as possible. And there's a lot of time and effort that goes into it. You have to understand like shading, lighting, depth, field. Like VFX artists, you have to have a really good understanding of like real life mechanics along digital as well. Okay. So we got our base shapes down. I'm always so scared of erasing. Like, I've seen plenty of memes about, like, people erasing, then they crinkle the paper. That is legit, like, the worst thing that can happen. Especially, like, once you do all the liner, all the work. Yeah, I think for these outer triangles, I'm gonna put little arrow shapes inside. So I don't want them to be too solid filled. I think that'll be a bit too much. I think same thing with these inner shapes too. I mean, that's the nice thing about doing sketch arts like this. They're not like big final pieces. They're not on like expensive watercolor paper. So you can kind of just go with the flow, see where it takes you. I had to touch up that edge, that one got kind of skinny. Okay, so those are all filled in. I'm going to go ahead, touch up some edges, and fill in the remainder of the triangle edges. Okay, let's go ahead and check in. Kind of looks like, you know, the cartoony sense you draw in the corner when you're like five. That kind of vibe. I think this area is a bit too white along the top. I kind of want to whiten out the line, the arches. I think that definitely looks a bit better. not sure what else to add here. I like the combination of rounded and straight edges. I think that looks very nice. I think adding an implied line along the edge here and then filling the rest in black will look nice. That way it's not too much empty white here. Let's go ahead and try that. I like same thing here. Tapered edge. It's funny how fast it slid down. Okay. Let's check in. Oh, that looks much better. With that filled in black. Really like how this one is looking. I think... because I like how this part is majority black. And then this area is majority white. I think if I add white down here on the more black side, I think that'll be a bit much. So I think this one... very good. I'm going to go ahead and touch up some of the edges, some white. That way we just get a bit more defined edge. So we get the nice taper. Cool. And I think this one is done. Cool. Next. This one is gonna kind of look maybe like piano keys, because I want to try and do bars up. And then some other type of design on this half. I think doing vertical bars. And then maybe actually coloring this in. Yeah, there's going to be another implied line down the center of this one. Gotta love those. I personally like to freehand my lines. Like, I despise rulers. Unless I'm using it for like an actual project. Let's see how straight these are. It's another reason why I like doing sketch cards. It's definitely a little practice. That line came out a little bit rough, but that's okay. Look at that. It kind of looks like roller coaster almost. Now I kind of want to do vertical line, same concept. Maybe. Kind of a weird line. Do something more like that. See, that has a really nice, feels natural, that movement. There we go. Looks a bit better, that flows a bit nicer. Yeah, I'm trying to get the lines just about parallel to the other half. This is when it'd be good to have a ruler. Mind you, I have one. I just don't want to use it. It kind of looks like that implied curvature is like bleeding in between. That looks nice. Yeah, I think it's time to color. I'm just changing the color filter, that way it'll be a bit more true to the actual color. I kinda wanna do rainbow in this one. Right now I'm just testing out and swatching. I kind of want to do a bit mirror of a lighter hue on this one. Don't want to do two bright colors. This actually came out perfect. I wasn't planning on doing 12 bars, but like the rainbow will perfectly fit for two rounds. Worked out, man. That. Nice. Thinking about whether I should do like black bars across. I think that'll look interesting to add a little bit more. I'm gonna go ahead and change my Sharpie instead of my Micron. Let's check in. Yeah, definitely think that black adds a lot to it. Okay. Oh, nope. Okay, now I think all the bars are filled in. Go check in. Oh, I love that. Look at that. So pretty. I think this one is done for today. Love how this one came out. This one came out amazing. I think the black bars do a lot as well. Add a lot of kind of intensifies that movement of that implied line there. Nice. Okay, I think I have time to do one more. So I'm planning on doing three, but this is kind of fun. The first two are kind of simple, that's why they took not as long. I think last one for today. I'm gonna go ahead and go straight in with some circles. I have to fix that edge. Oh, I clipped it. I clipped it. You can't see, but I clipped it. When I flipped the paper over, I clipped the white gel. You see it's smeared now. Yeah, all better. All better. Kind of looks like seashell shaped almost, those curves. Yeah, for this one. Still thinking about what I should do about the empty space. Okay, let's check in. Look at that. Definitely like. Oh, this looks more gray. Yeah, I think this is good. I don't think there's anything that I'm gonna add because I think if I add like white highlights, it'll be a bit much. Kind of looks weird how those are like split up. But I think that's okay. Cool. I think that is all I got for today. So just to go over what we did today, we got this one. Let's go ahead and change the color filter real quick. There we go, a bit more true color. And then finally this one. Nice. Cool. Once again, thank you for tuning in. So I'll be back again tomorrow, 10 a.m. Hopefully nothing gets scuffed again. So yeah. Thank you. Guys, have a great day.